Okay, folks, it's a brand new year, and I can't wait to see what kind of trouble I can get myself into in 2016. But hey, we're not here about this today. I just thought it would be a nice opening picture for my video. We're going to look at something different, so stand by. Okay, so this is a tune bass. And let's open it up and see what we got. Hope everybody had a great holiday season. I'd like to welcome all my new subscribers and shout out to all my old subscribers. And here we go, it's the tune bass. Oh my goodness, would you look at that. So, we'll put it on the bench. I'll explain why it's here. And then I'll try and figure out why it's here. Okay. So apparently, the person that owns this, and this was sort of brought to me by a guy I do stuff for. This is his friend. Okay. And there's some mention of open core or exposed core strings being installed on this. And there's some concern about the setup. Okay, so I gotta do some more research, but that's not an exposed core string, because if it was, the core would be, it would be all tiny, and then it would get bigger, and the core would actually go over top the saddle. That's my understanding of open core, exposed core. Apparently, exposed core strings are supposed to give you more sustain. I have no idea. But I gotta do a little research and get some more info. I mean, the playability seems pretty good. If you play one of these type of things, let's just hold on and try that out for a second. So if the core of the string were exposed, that would make the string action drop. So you'd want to bring it up a little bit, but it seems I don't know, it seems to play okay, and I'm told that the tuning is C and a B, so the strings I like are stuck in the middle. Who knows, let's do a little research, see what we can figure out. There's a picture off the internet of what an exposed core bass string looks like. And you can see, you see how the center core wire goes over top the saddle? Okay. I don't see that on those strings. So, I don't know. I'm totally confused. Let's see what we can find out about tune bass. Well, that's the puppy. A tune TWB63, custom TWB63 BP 6 string bass Burl Poplar top. Not an economically priced machine by any means, but reviews, specification, tune guitar technology. I gotta go to their website, see if I can get some specs as to how this. Oh look, you can drag over that. See? You see those strings there? That looks just like what is on it. Those do not have exposed cores. Not at all. Tune guitar technology. Let's search their website. Okay, so I found them. These guys are in Korea. They got a bunch of downloads, but we'll click on that. Come on. So they talk a lot about the wiring and the electronics. No information as to the recommended string height. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do what we all do. Support. Let's contact them. And, frick, they have a telephone number. The email. There we go. That's as good as it gets. Information, history. Okay. It's not a click, it won't open my... Alright, gonna email them. Hold on. Recommended string height. What is the recommended string height measurement on your six-string bass guitar model TWB63NF? Thank you. Now just, I'm gonna just back up. Maybe I'm confused. Let's just back up. So, possibly I misunderstand. Maybe this had exposed core strings on it and he switched to these. I'm just going to go look in the case and see what I find in the case up there. Just hang on. There's a nice little paper in here about how to adjust the truss rod. Then I find a brand new set of strings, DM2698. Now, maybe I'm totally screwed in the head, and these are the exposed core strings that I'm supposed to install on the guitar. But super brilliance, all wire used, hand check for consistency. Without opening up the pack, I can't tell. So now I'm on to text message land, trying to figure out what the hell I'm supposed to be doing. Oh God, it just never gets easy. Okay. So right now, string action at the 12th fret is 5/64 of an inch, which is, to me, is pretty respectable. Anything lower than this, big old B string just gonna flop into the frets. But like I said, maybe I'm confused. Maybe it had exposed core strings on it and he's put these on. Or maybe those strings in the case are the ones God, how do I get myself into this? Well, a friend of a friend once told me that's how it starts, right? That's this video. So this guy's going back in the case till I get some more information. Let's move on. Thanks for watching today's episode with the Tune Guitar Technologies 6-string bass guitar. Cheers, folks. Okay. I'm an idiot. Well, you know, many people have claimed that. I'll admit it. Yes. These new strings are apparently the exposed core strings. They're going to be installed on the bass, which would technically make the string action drop because there's not as much material going over top of the saddle. So, with that in mind, wish me luck. I'll take some measurements, try and recreate what's already here, and away we go. Enough confusion for one freaking day. Cheers. Not to hell with it. I'm not signing off. I'm just going to keep going. Okay, now it's all making sense. God. Okay, so you can see the string action is going to have to drop a bit. So we're going to have to raise this up a little bit. And that's what I'm going to do right now. As soon as I find the right hex key, I'm thinking Korea, so I'm thinking metric. Okay, so I won. metric, and it seems that one complete revolution of the wrench brings us back up to 564s here. So I'll continue to change the rest of strings. Now, gonna have to check the intonation too. I don't think it's going to affect things because the break point should really be the same, I believe. Maybe not. Have to check it out. Three down, three to go. I'm only doing these one at a time. I don't want to send the neck into some sort of cardiac arrest by taking all the strings off it. Scary. Just for the record, that one does not have an exposed core. I'm looking at the C string and it doesn't either. Okay, so chances are I won't have to adjust the string height on that one. So as predicted, the string height didn't change on the C and the G string. Only on the ones on the heavier strings where the chord's exposed. So I'm going to go through it all again, and let's do some intonation checks as well. Stand by. I got the old Peterson going, and tweaking the intonation. Let's see what happens. So the exposed core pushes the break point back, whereas the wound string sits way up proud and the break point is farther ahead. So all these guys, the intonation went flat. So there it is, the six string tuned bass, all happy, with exposed core strings on it now. After Dave's brain fart and much confusion, it's all done. So I will now say cheers. Take care, folks.